Hello, my name is Angie Kunanen, and I've attended Aquinas High School for the past 4 years. In this video, I will reflect on who I used to be and how Aquinas slowly but surely shaped me into the woman I am today.
1, 2, 3, 4.
Let's start all the way back in probably the worst year of my life, 2015. As a freshman, I was undoubtedly, undeniably a loser. An awkward teen with horrible, furly eyebrows that I refused to get done, and approximately two people who I could really call friends.
When the trench is new and blue in a French, I'm in!
Worst of all, I was lazy. So much so that I purposely took classes that were stupidly easy for me. But, you know, this didn't stop me from getting poor grades and using all of my time for the internet. I would spend 70% of my class time scrolling through my obnoxious fan blog making more obnoxious Hamilton memes because I genuinely thought that fan content would be my fast pass to fame. Spoiler alert, it wasn't. Outside of school, I also did nothing. So while my old classmates were joining swimming, softball, volleyball, the musical, and all sorts of other activities, I spent my hours in the girls' locker room, which I appropriately called my second house. And as sad as it may sound, that was basically my freshman year. And if it weren't for the guidance of some of my teachers and the encouragement of some of my classmates, I probably would have stayed on that path. Or I guess, that house. Now, sophomore year is where things started to look up. For one, I joined mock trial, which was honestly so much fun. It really ignited my weird fascination with law, the roles of attorneys, and just general court proceedings. At the time, most of the team was seniors, so I was designated to be captain for next year. Remember that fact, because it's gonna come back. In the meanwhile, I also joined the plays, which is still responsible for my most fond and favorite high school memories. And did I mention that this was the year I picked up my iconic ukulele? Yep, and even though my ukulele skills at the time were graham crackers are underrated, I don't know why, questionable, my newfound friends and teachers still pushed me to improve, and now I have a semi-successful ukulele YouTube account with over 1,000 subscribers! And in terms of my social life, I actually had one this year! Going into sophomore year, I was determined to challenge myself, so, you know, I took a lot harder classes. And I mean, sharing your entire schedule with the same 15 kids definitely helps you make friends. For me, sophomore year marks a year of growth. My more challenging schedule helped me to curb that little internet addiction, and my extracurriculars filled me with the confidence that I definitely lacked as a freshman. And the whole time, I had newfound friends alongside me. Definitely the most busy year ever. I was taking 4 AP classes, 2 honors classes, so there was no more slacking off for this gal. Let's see, remember how I was captain of mock trial? Well, that came back to bite me because not only did I have an insanely difficult schedule, but I had a new mock trial team to teach the ins and outs of the competition a week before the competition. Even if our team was barely viable, we actually did pretty well, and I actually ended up having my efforts recognized by the County of San Bernardino. I also started a glee club! It wasn't anything too big, but it was a safe space for me and my friends to bond over music. And during my junior year, I actually wrote a small play for my club, which we performed during the winter showcase. And the reaction was... These two instances were actually the first time I had to step up and be a leader, which is really jarring for someone who usually works exclusively independently. But, you know, I think Aquinas was really the best place for me to develop my skills as a leader. In an everyone-knows-everybody type of environment, it doesn't take much to form relationships with people. My familiarity with the people around me gave me assurance that everything was gonna turn out okay, even if there was a couple of bumps. Speaking of bumps, if my academic year was an ice cream flavor, it'd be Rocky Road because, oh my goodness, it was very rough. I remember my AP Chem grades literally looked like a game of bingo, but it put me to work. And by second semester, I was on top of my game. I had nearly all A's for the first time in my life. And I even passed the AP Chem exam. What I think my favorite part was that no matter how challenging the material was, I had so much fun in class that it really didn't matter. My little AP family made classes so much more bearable, and my teachers really catered to our way of learning, while also keeping it really fun and lighthearted. I mean, look at these memes, dude! So, senior year. I can't say much about it for sure, but while it was definitely full of firsts, I realized I just completely forgot how to draw the brows. My senior year was mostly filled with memorable lasts. Close it. There we go! And that's all I really have right now, because I'm sure second semester will have so much more. In the end, I am incredibly grateful that I went to Aquinas. Because I feel like the school allowed me to do so much more that I wouldn't have been able to do anywhere else. Thanks to all these opportunities, classes, teachers, clubs, and friends, I was able to grow into someone who was confident in her work, intellect, leadership, and character. I am now someone who isn't afraid to show and use their talents for good. And really, that wouldn't have been possible without Aquinas, my real second home.